when I had to deal with the issue of digital vibes, not only is it that I actually started the investigation because it was brought to my attention, and I actually handed over the report to the SIU, and the report of the SIU contained exactly the issues that I had found in the report. At a certain point, I then approached the president to say, I would rather resign because the report of the SIU was faulty, it was baseless, and it made all sorts of allegations. And I said, they had approached this problem from a point of view of trying to find me guilty at all costs. So I resigned. I was not pushed. I was not asked by the president to resign. I was not asked by the ANC to resign. I think that all leaders need to be able to face up to the issues of allegations, because these allegations must then be dealt with by the individual. For example, in my view, I would say that when the president says he's innocent, we should believe the president and then allow him to go through to prove that with the parliamentary process, so that that process must then be given all the evidence and close the matter at that point. Now, the ANC, in the last discussion, I've been critical of how we discussed the matter because not all of us were able to speak. Ordinarily, we speak everything inside, get the summary resolution that contains all the views of the people who have been participating. And then, of course, after that, we all keep quiet because all our views are contained there. This time around, this is not how it happened. And we've been objecting to the chairperson who prematurely closed the meeting and muzzled a number of members. Now, I believe that's not the right way to run the organization because it begins to give you a resolution that might be misleading to the public. And therefore, you end up with all these issues having to be debated this way. I think that the speaker and the processes of parliament should be supported. And I believe that in the process of all of that, we should support that if the president feels that there are issues that he's not happy with. You see, at the end of the day, none of us know what are the facts on this matter, but the president knows, so he can object. And if the president goes to take the matter to court for review, that's his right and we shouldn't interfere with it.